You may need to add or remove empty rows or columns in Google Sheets to keep things organized or make space for new information. There are several ways you can delete rows and columns. I've got our vacation budget here, and you will notice that in some areas we have extra rows and columns, while in others we're missing some. The first way to delete a row is by selecting it, right-clicking, and going to delete row. I can do that not just for one row, but select multiple by pressing Shift while selecting, and then right-click to delete. This option to delete is also available in the Google Sheets menu under Edit and then Delete Selected Rows. To delete a column, select it and then click on the arrow down next to column letter and scroll down to delete column. What is also very useful is being able to delete rows and columns that are not consecutive. I'm going to select column C, then press Command on Mac or Control on PC and select my other column F, then right click and select Delete Selected Columns. This is especially useful when you have many empty rows throughout the worksheet. Select non-consecutive rows while pressing Shift and then right-click to delete them. I'm going to clean up the worksheet a bit more by deleting some of the empty rows at the top. Just as with deleting rows and columns, there are also several ways to insert new ones. Let's say we want to add some space between our Dallas and New York City budget. We can select row 13, then right-click and insert one row either above or below the selected row. Now, to insert multiple rows at once, you have to select the number of rows you want to insert. So if I want to insert three new rows, I will select that many, then right click, and now we have an option to either insert three new rows above or below. If you make a mistake, undo with Command plus Z on Mac or Control plus Z on PC. You can also use the Google Sheets menu to insert rows or columns. Select one or multiple rows, then go to Insert rows and select either above or below. To insert multiple columns, select one, Shift select the last one, then go to Insert columns and insert left or right. The number of columns listed will be dependent on the number you selected. One less known trick is that you can also insert cells in your spreadsheets. This is especially useful when you just want to shift data in one part of your spreadsheet. You don't want to move all the data left, right, or up and down, but rather just move section of your sheet. To move one cell, select it, then go to Insert, and then specify how you want to shift the cells, either shift right or shift down. You can select multiple cells and do the same. This is probably more likely the way you would use this option. If you select most of your data in a row and opt to use the insert cells option, it would be almost as if you inserted a new row. Thanks so much for watching.